everyone, and welcome to In the Huddle, your weekly high school football roundup. I'm Dom Costantino from the Intelligencer, and with me as always is Kevin Cooney. How you doing, Kev?
Nice to see you, Dom.
And this is week 11 of the high school football season, kind of hard to believe. We're actually getting set now for the playoffs in most of the PIAA schools. Although the Catholic League has started the week before.
Playoffs?
And we're going to run through everything both in the District 1 Quad A bracket, Kev, as well as District 1 AAA, and even a little bit of District 11 AA with Palisades up there in Upper Bucks County.
And District 12 AAA.
That's right. We also have the Catholic League and District 12 playoffs as well. Thanks for filling me in there.
Not a problem. That's my job.
And to get started at the top of the Quad A bracket in District 1, Kev, we've got the number one seed, North Penn, which is the only undefeated team in District 1 Quad A at 10-0, ranked nationally, ranked very high in the state. They're playing Council Rock North, which is coming off their fourth loss of the season last week in their rivalry game to Council Rock South. What can we expect in this game, Kev?
Well, I see this game playing out. Council Rock North needed everything to go right to get in the tournament. They needed three teams above them, Perkiomen Valley, Glen Mills, and Saturn to lose just to get in after they lost to South on Friday night. Look, I think North has enough talent to hang around. You know, you look at Ty Bostein, you look at Hamilton, you look at Brandon Cottom, you look at Lee Marble. There's a good talented core here, but I don't think it's enough to compete with the skill position players that North Penn has. North Penn just comes at you in waves. Look, this is not going to be an easy game when you look at it as far as it's not going to be a 35-point walkover, but I don't think Council Rock North has enough weapons to hang in there long-term. I would expect maybe a 2-3 touchdown game, somewhere like that. It's Quakertown traveling to Haven Grove, and Dom, what do you see out of this one?
Well, on the Quakertown side, the Panthers are coming off probably their biggest win of the season. They went to Souderton last week in a game they didn't necessarily need to win to get into the playoffs against a Souderton team that was really rolling. And Quakertown took it to them. I mean, they were physical in a way I think that people didn't expect them to be. And, you know, they were really in control of the game, and they came up with a big defensive stop at the end. However, this is a very good Avon Grove team. I think, you know, this is a team that had played in the Southern Chester County League in the past. They moved up to the Chestmont with the realignment of the Chestmont, and they managed to earn a tie in the big school division of the Chestmont League with Downingtown West and Downingtown East. They're coming off a 48-12 win over Coatesville, where they had a couple of running backs. Brandon Monk rushed for 139 yards, and the guy that Quakertown's really going to have to look out for is Brendan McLaughlin, the big fullback who's 6 foot, 205 pounds. It's going to present another big physical challenge for Quakertown. Moving down the bracket in District 1, perhaps the most intriguing first-round matchup we have is a rematch between Neshaminy, the number 8 seed, and Abington, the number 9. Kev, these two teams had played back on September the 25th at Schwartzman Stadium in Abington, with Abington winning a very entertaining game, 28-24. This time they take it to Heartbreak Ridge. What do you see in the rematch? Can we expect anything different this time?
Well, I think the one thing to expect is, you know, Neshaminy cannot make the same mistakes they made the first time around against Abington. Really, they can't make the same mistakes they made against Bensbury last week. A ton of special teams mistakes, a couple fumbles. You know, you can't win games consistently, especially in the postseason against good opponents like that. The one question I have about Abington at this point is going to be the status of wide receiver Anthony Hensley. Hensley suffered an ankle injury last week. Talked to Tim Sorber on Wednesday. He says that it's a game-time decision pretty much. Call him questionable using the NFL parlance. Remember, Hensley had double-digit figures in receptions in that first game. Really was dominant in the first half before Neshaminy started to roll the defense over. And if Hensley's not right, I think that really makes the job tough for Abington on the road. Gives Sam Kind, takes another weapon away from Sam Kind. Hensley was probably the best receiver in the National this year. Two 3A games in two different districts. We'll start with Upper Moreland and Pottsgrove. Upper Moreland, one of the last teams into the District 1 3A bracket, gets to play Pottsgrove. This is a little bit of Mission Impossible, isn't it, here for Upper Moreland?
Nothing's impossible. Nothing's ever impossible, but Upper Moreland's got their work cut out for them. They're coming off a tough 27-0 loss to Norristown at home, which certainly didn't do them any favors. However, they were able to kind of slide into the district playoffs, in part because they played only 9 games. They were able to finish ahead of Westchester, Henderson, Radnor, and Strathaven, albeit barely. But in Pottsgrove, they're getting a big challenge. This is a team that pretty much hammered everybody they played. They beat Penridge in week 1 at Poppy Yoder. They've got a dual threat quarterback in Terrell Chestnut that can run it or throw it. Penn State's recruiting him. Micah Polamalu, who's the cousin of Steelers safety Troy Polamalu, is a running back for this team. They've got a big linebacker. Hamlet, you know, a lot of challenges. Going to be tough for Upper Moreland going on the road in this game. And down at the bottom of the bracket, Kevin, the two-seed Pensbury coming off the big overtime win over their rival, Neshaminy. They get Unionville. And what do you see here in this game?
What I see in this game is Pensbury is just going to run the football. And I'm not sure Unionville can stop it, quite frankly. I think Pensbury does what they do very well. They run the football. They play tough defense. They force teams into mistakes. That kind of to me lends to a big win probably at Falcon Field. And you're talking an interesting tournament. I think Pensbury had a couple tough weeks here, but I can see them now starting to get on a little bit of a roll as we move forward in this tournament.
And down toward the bottom of the bracket, we have the Council Rock South Golden Hawks at 8-2 in the playoffs for the first time, taking on Ridley. They're going to go down the blue route to play the 9-1 Ridley team, Kev. And this is kind of an interesting matchup as well, is it not?
It's an interesting matchup, especially because the one contrast, I think, in these two teams is the fact Ridley's there every year, and this is South's first trip in the tournament. Billy Fleming has had a good year for South, but that Ridley style, just the way their offense runs and the way everything kind of goes with that, I think for a team that hasn't been there, it's a real difficult thing to cope with. South will hang tough, but I kind of like Ridley in this one. Now we've gone through five of Class A, of the eight Class 4A games in District 1. Who's gonna win this thing in 3 weeks?
I think we're going to see North Penn and Pensbury play in the final. I think it's what we've kind of expected. It was going to be whoever came out of the National Conference as well as North Penn. And I think the way the brackets are set up and the way things are going to play out, we're going to have a North Penn-Pensbury final.
The other 3A game to look for is actually the Catholic League 3A championship between North Catholic and Archbishop Wood. Wood struggles to beat Lanesdale Catholic last week. Kind of gets a little lucky, had some breaks go their way at the end. North Catholic rallies to beat Egan. You saw North. Do they have enough to match up with Wood next week?
I don't think so. These teams played 2 weeks ago. Wood won 24-7 at Wissahickon, their home field. North relies heavily on Eugene Bird. Conwell Egan did a terrific job keeping him in check for most of that game. He finished with 124 yards, but he got most of it late as North mounted its comeback. But Egan really made a bunch of mistakes, turning the ball over, a ton of fumbles, things like that, that I just don't see Wood doing for a second week in a row. I think if anything, the Lansdale Catholic scare will be something of a wake-up call for Wood. They should again be the 3A champs, and I see them again getting out of the city and possibly then meeting Pottsgrove a couple weeks down the road in the 3A playoffs.
Final game we'll talk about is District 11 Class AA action. It's Catasauqua and Palisades. And Dom, what are you looking for?
Well, these two teams played one of the better games that I've seen all season back on September 25th. Catasauqua won 31-21. Palisades kind of made a bunch of mistakes where they shot themselves in the foot. They were the more physical team in that game, and it was one of the more frustrating losses for Coach Brian Gilbert and the Pirates. Palisades coming in at 6-4. They're the sixth seed. Catasauqua coming off a loss last week to Northwestern Lehigh, but still managed to secure the three seed in this game. Going to be tough going on the road. Palisades knows what they have to do. They can't make a lot of the mistakes that have hurt them in several of their four losses this year where they turn the ball over. They've got a high-powered offense. They have a tendency to turn the ball over. They're going to need to avoid that this week to turn the tables on Caddy.
And that'll do it for this week's In the Huddle, Week 11. Can you believe that?
Yeah. Getting near the end of the line here, Kev. We're going to have to go our separate ways soon.
Wow. I'll be heartbroken when that happens.
I'm sure you will.
For Dom Constantino, I'm Kevin Cooney. Thanks for joining us in the huddle. Remember to read the paper on Sunday for all the updates, and remember to check out BucksMountainSportsNow.com for all your high school football action this weekend. We'll see you next week in the huddle.